triangle. Then let's color in that shape. Yeah, there you go. You could also add it, make it a little wider if you want. Perfect. Then let's draw the mouth. We're going to draw a line that comes down, and then we're going to curve out to the side on the left, and then also on the right. There's our bear's mouth.
Yeah.
Okay, now let's draw the eyes. I'm going to draw a circle over here on the left, and the same size circle over here on the right. Now, if we ever go too fast, what can our friends do?
Pause the video.
Yeah, you guys can pause the video if you need extra time.
Swear I won't forget this, why do I regret this? In my mind reckless, thoughts are feeling endless. Sitting up, I'm breathless, anxiety's infectious. I feel so defenseless, betrayed and embarrassed. I hate being open, I hate being broken. I feel like an ocean filled up with... Never at home, need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. Every breath hold, cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold, cause I can't move on till I let go.
two lines, diagonal lines that come up like this, and then I'm going to connect them back into the head.
Olivia Polar Bear.
Yeah, Olivia Polar Bear. You guys can add even more details to your drawings if you want. Now, let's draw the scarf. I'm going to draw a curve that comes across the bottom and connects both sides of the head. Then let's draw the side of our polar bear's legs.
Yeah.
You can draw them the same length, right in the middle. Yeah. And then we can connect those two with a curve on top. Then let's draw the bottom of our polar bear's feet or legs. We'll draw a little curve that connects both sides. And then let's also add the toes. I'm going to add two little curves on each. What's our polar bear missing?
His arms.
Yeah, or her arms. Let's draw a curve that comes out, around, and then back in. It looks like a sideways U shape. And then we can do the same thing over here on the right. We'll draw the same U shape, comes around, and then back in. Awesome. Our two polar bears look a little different, but they're both turning out awesome.
Yeah.
And it's okay if their drawings look different too, right?
Yeah, because the most important thing is to have fun.
And to?
Practice.
Practice. Remember to practice. Now what is our polar bear missing?
Skis.
Yeah, we're drawing them skiing. Okay, let's first draw one ski on the left side. We're going to draw a line that comes out like this, a diagonal line, and then we're going to curve up at the end. Yes. Then we're going to draw another line that matches like this line right here. So the same direction. Yes. And then we're going to curve around.
What? Hear what I say. We are the business today. Fuck shit is finished today. All T and J. We the new. Come on.
a polar bear.
But skiing.
Yeah, we're going to draw him snow skiing or her snow skiing. We hope you're going to follow along with us. You need your drawing supplies. You ready to start?
Yeah.
Let's first draw our polar bear's nose. We're going to draw a V, letter V, a really small letter V in the middle of our paper. And then we can connect the top and turn it into a triangle. Then let's color in that shape. Yeah, there you go. You could also make it a little wider if you want. Perfect. Then let's draw the mouth. We're going to draw a line that comes down, and then we're going to curve out to the side on the left, and then also on the right. There's our bear's mouth.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, now let's draw the eyes. I'm going to draw a circle over here on the left and the same size circle over here on the right. If we ever go too fast, what can our friends do?
Pause the video.
Yeah, you guys can pause the video if you need extra time. Okay, now let's draw a small oval or a circle in the top left of our polar bear's eyes. Oh, I love it. This is for the highlight to make our eyes look shiny. Now let's color in the big circle, but leave that little circle white. I'm going to add eyelashes to my polar bear, but you can leave them off if you want to. Are you drawing a boy?
Yes.
Okay, of course. All right, now let's draw the top of our polar bear's head. We're going to start over here on the left side, and we're going to draw an upside down U that goes over and down. There you go. And then let's draw the ears. I'm going to draw a circle, or part of a circle, or an upside down U shape. And we can draw that same U shape over here. Let's draw the inside of our polar bear's ears. We'll draw smaller upside down U's in. Inside of the ears. Now we can, let's extend the head down just a little further. Oh, I know what I'm going to add too. I've been doing this drawing for Hadley. Olivia, I'm going to draw a little bow. I'm going to draw an upside down U here, two lines, diagonal lines that come up like this, and then I'm going to connect them back into the head.
Olivia, polar bear.
You guys can add even more details to your drawings if you want. Now, let's draw the scarf. I'm going to draw a curve that comes across the bottom and connects both sides of the head. Then let's draw the side of the scarf over here. We'll draw the left and then also the right side. And then let's also draw the bottom of our scarf coming across and connecting those two sides together. Okay, now when you wrap the scarf around, you also leave a little extra hanging down, right? So we can draw two little lines coming down further. Let's connect those at the bottom. add one more. We're going to draw it behind the first one we drew, so the a small letter L. Yeah. And we could also add the little strings that hang down from the end of the scarf. Okay, now let's draw the body. We're going to start over here, and we're going to draw a short line that comes down on each side. Yeah. And then we can draw, let's draw a little curve that comes in just a little bit, not too far. And then let's, yeah, one there, and then one on the other side. I like it. And we can draw the legs. We're going to draw two lines. We're going to draw a short line down over here and a short line on the right side. And we're going to draw two more lines. I'm going to draw one here and one here. This is for the inside of our polar bear's legs.
Yeah.
You can draw them the same length right in the middle. Yeah. And then we can connect those. Two with a curve on top. Then let's draw the bottom of our polar bear's feet or legs. We'll draw a little curve that connects both sides. And then let's also add the toes. I'm going to add two little curves on each. What's our polar bear missing?
His arms.
Yeah, or her arms. Let's draw a curve that comes out, around, and then back in. It looks like a sideways U shape. And then we can do the same thing over here on the right. We'll draw the same U shape, comes around, and then... back in. All of a sudden, our two polar bears look a little different, but they're both turning out awesome.
Yeah.
And it's okay if their drawings look different too, right?
Yeah, because the most important thing is to have fun.
And to?
Practice.
Practice. Remember to practice. Now what is our polar bear missing?
Skis.
Yeah, we're drawing them skiing. Okay, let's first draw one ski on the left side. We're going to draw a line that comes out like this, a diagonal line, and then we're going to curve up at the end. Yes, then we're going to draw another line that matches, like this line right here, so the same direction. Yes, and then we're going to curve around like this and connect to the ski. Let's do the same thing on the right side, but we're going to aim it going the other direction. And then right at the end, let's draw a little curve coming up. And then we'll draw that same line we're going to match over here. Then we're going to connect this line. We're going to curve up and connect. To the outside. Oh, that looks so cool. Let's draw the back of our skis. So we're going to imagine this line going behind the leg, coming back like this. We'll draw a little diagonal line. We can draw it on each side. Yes. And then we're going to connect it right into the leg. That looks super 3D. Now let's draw the ski poles. We're going to draw a line that comes through the paw and down like that. And then at the very bottom, we're going to draw a circle like that.
Can you make this a little bit longer?
Oh, yeah, definitely longer. There you go. And then inside, we could draw a little X. Let's do the same thing over here on this side. We'll draw a line that comes down through the paws. We want it to be the same length as the other side. Then we're going to draw that circle or oval that matches. And then we'll draw the X on the inside of that circle. We did it! We finished drawing our polar bear skiing.
But we still need a color.
This part we're gonna fast forward. At the end, you could pause the video if you want to match our same coloring. You ready to fast forward?
Yeah.
Awesome! We finished coloring.
My job is to make college easier because students have a lot on their own.
Hey, friends, today we're going to draw a dolphin.
Yeah, we're going to draw a super cute one. We hope you're going to follow along, right?
Mm-hmm.
You got your marker?
Yeah.
All right, where is it? You ready to start?
Yeah.
Oh, hang on to that marker really tight. Okay, now, the first step we're going to do is we're going to draw our dolphin's eye. We're going to draw it right here. We're going to draw a circle. We're going to draw it kind of big. So we're going to draw a cartoon dolphin.
Right here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go. Good. And then in the top right of the eye, let's draw another circle. And then in the bottom left, let's draw a smaller circle. These are our favorite cartoon eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're going to color the big circle, but leave those two little circles white. Next, we're going to draw the top of our dolphin. We're going to start right next to his eye, and we're going to draw, because they have four heads, so we're going to draw a curve like this, but then it's going to come down further, and we're going to draw him jumping out of the water.
They have four. Heads?
Yeah, four heads. Like forehead. That's a forehead.
Oh, I think said four heads.
No. Okay, so you can start right here and then draw a forehead. Right here, and then a curve down. Four heads.
Four heads.
Dolphins have four heads.
Like, what? Four heads?
Let's draw his tail a little longer. Let's draw it down here and extend it a little further. And then let's draw their nose.
Who's ready to hatch some cool pets? Click here to make your very...
Hair friend Sarah and draw a present.
Yeah, with Santa Claus inside the present when you open it up.
Yeah.
We hope you're going to follow along. You need your drawing supplies. We like using markers, but you can use whatever you have at home. You also need...
some paper and something to color with.
Yeah, you ready to start?
Yes.
We actually don't need our markers first. We're going to put those off to the side, and we're going to fold our paper. Let's take the top edge, line it up with the bottom edge, like so, crease it down the middle, and then out to the corners. Then we're going to... take the top flap and this bottom edge, we're going to fold it back up to the top edge, line it up, and crease it down. Then let's flip it over. And we're going to repeat that same step. We're going to take this top flap, line it up with the top edge, and crease it down. This last fold is just a guide fold, so let's unfold it and flatten it out. Then let's flip our paper back over. When we're all done, it should open up like this. We also have scratch paper we're going to put underneath our drawing paper. This is to protect our table because we're drawing with markers. The scratch paper doesn't have to be red. I just like it because it matches our table. Now we're ready to draw, and we're going to... to draw our present first. So let's first draw the left side of our present. We're going to start over here, and we're going to draw a line that goes across the fold and comes down close to the bottom. Then let's draw the bottom of our present. We're going to draw a horizontal line coming across. Looks like the letter L.
Yeah.
Then we're going to draw another line coming down for the right side of our present. And let's connect the top of these two lines together. There's our present shape, or our present.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's draw the ribbon. We're going to draw two lines coming straight down the middle of our square or box. Shape. Yeah, and I think it's easier to draw the lines coming down from the top so that it's easier when you draw across the fold.
Yeah.
Now let's draw the knot for our bow. We're going to draw an upside down U right in the middle. Then let's draw a diagonal line coming out of the knot on the left side and also over on the right side. Side. And we could also draw a line curving down and connecting to the present. And let's repeat that same step on the right side. Let's also draw two wrinkle lines inside of the bow. We could draw it on the left and also on the right. We did it. We finished drawing our present. That's pretty simple. Now let's open up our paper. We can flatten it out so it's easier to draw on. We're going to extend the present up a little higher. Then let's connect these two lines together. This is the bottom of our present. Down here, and we also have the lid up here at the top. Let's also connect or extend the ribbon line up to the top of this box. And then let's also draw the bottom of the lid over here. So we're going to draw a line coming across and connecting to the other side. We did it. We finished drawing our present. Now, you could draw anything inside of your present. Well, who are we going to draw again?
Santa Claus.
Yeah. Let's start by drawing his nose. Let's draw an oval shape in the middle of our paper above this fold. Then let's draw his eyes. I'm going to draw a circle on the left and a circle over here on the right. Then we can also draw a highlight inside of his eyes. We'll draw a smaller oval shape on both eyes. And then let's color in the eyes, but leave the highlight white. This makes the eyes look shiny.
Especially for Santa.
Yeah. Anytime we speed up the video, what can our art friends do?
Pause the video.
Yeah, for extra time. All right, now let's draw. Draw Santa's beard. We're going to start here on the left side of his eye. We're going to draw a U shape that comes under his nose and eyes and back up on the right side of his eye.
Yeah, it almost looks like a smile.
Oh, it does. A really big smile. Now let's draw his hat. We're going to start over here and we're going to draw a curve that connects. Yes, and then let's also draw two lines coming up higher on each side. This is the fuzzy part. At the bottom of his hat.
Yeah.
And then we can connect those two lines together also. Next, we can draw the pom-pom on the end of Santa's hat. I'm going to draw a circle over here on the left side. Then let's draw a curve coming out of the pom-pom to the right. Then right here, we're going to draw a little curve that comes up and connects to that other curve. Then let's draw the top of the hat. We're going to start here, and we're going to connect to the present first. And then we're going to imagine that going up inside of the present and then coming down on the right side.
It's a big hat.
It is a big hat. Now let's draw the rest of his beard. We're going to start over here on the left side of the hat. And we're going to draw a U shape that comes down further. This is the bottom of his beard coming down really far. And then back up to the hat. Yes, keep going. You did it. Now let's draw his mouth. And he's super happy, right? Santa is very jolly. So that doesn't look like a happy mouth.
Yeah.
Let's draw it open, really happy. There we go. That's even happier. Happier. And we can also draw a tongue inside. And then let's color in the top shape of his mouth. What should we draw next?
His ears.
Yeah, let's do it. We could draw the letter C on the left and a backwards C on the right. Now let's draw his belly full of jelly.
Yeah.
We're gonna draw a curve starting here in his beard. And we're going to connect down to the present. And we're going to do the same thing on the right side. Let's also draw his belt. I'm going to draw a line that comes up, over, and then back down. This is the belt buckle.
Yeah.
And we could also draw that same shape inside, but smaller. And then let's draw the actual belt. We'll draw a line that comes across on the left side and also matching on the right side. Let's also draw the fuzzy part of his jacket. We'll draw one line down the middle. And then let's draw another line next to it on the left and also on the right.
Kind of like the Santa turkey.
Oh yeah, it is a lot like it. Now let's draw his arms and let's draw him up like he's yelling ho ho ho. We're gonna start here on his beard and we'll draw a short diagonal line coming up to the left and also one over here coming up to the right.
Those are some nice hands.
They look skinny. Yeah. Let's make them thicker. We're gonna draw the end of his sleeve. We'll draw a diagonal line coming back down and then another one coming into his body. Let's repeat that same step over here on the right side. We'll draw the end of the sleeve and then a curve coming in. Yes, let's also add the fluffy stuff on the end of his sleeve. We're going to draw a curve that comes out of his arm on the top and also on the bottom. And then we can connect those two together. If this line is curved, you could draw a curve that matches. If it's straight, you could draw this line straight too.
Yeah.
Let's repeat that same detail over here on the right side. A curve coming out of the top and also out of the bottom. And then mine's curved, so I'm going to match that same curve to complete the... little fuzzy end of the sleeve. Mm-hmm. Now let's draw his mittens. We're going to draw an upside down J for his thumb. Come out of the sleeve and then curve around, but a really short curve at the end. Then we're going to do the same thing, except really big for the end of the mitten or the rest of the fingers. You did it. Let's repeat that same step for the other hand or mitten. Let's draw the upside down J for the thumb. And then a big, it looks like another upside down J.
Yeah.
For the rest of his glove. We did it! We finished drawing Santa inside of a present.
Yeah.
That's a big present. Except we still need to do one more thing.
Color it.
Yeah, this part will fast forward, but at the end you could pause the video if you want to use our drawing.